Hey guys, so next Thursday, September 30th, is the activities fair. So go outside to the tennis courts. You'll see a bunch of tables and you'll see a bunch of posters of all the clubs that we offer here at BHS. If you're a club advisor or a leader, be on the lookout for a Google form that you can sign up for a spot at the activities fair. So tune in for that. Thanks, BHS.
These are the frequently asked questions from the Department of Elementary and Secondary Education and Department of Public Health. Number one, what is DESE's guidance on appropriate mask wearing? All individuals in schools, including those vaccinated, must wear masks. Masks must completely cover your nose and mouth and fit snugly against the sides of your face without gaps. Number two, are individuals considered close contacts if they're exposed to a COVID-19 positive individual while outdoors? No. Exposure time outdoors does not count towards the time-based close contact definition. Only time spent indoors should be considered for the purposes of identifying close contacts for students and staff. Close contacts are individuals who have been within 6 feet of a COVID-19 positive individual while indoors for at least 15 minutes cumulatively during a 24-hour period.
Helpful information. Principal Galante sends out a Monday memo every Monday. It is a helpful thing to read. Yes, it could seem a little long, but it is meant for all students with all kinds of preferences, and it is filled with a bunch of useful information. Activities, fairs, and upcoming events this week or month. Even if you scroll through the document, you will find things that may interest you or be very helpful. If you didn't read it this week, you should know PSAT testing is held in BHS on October 16th. The cost is only $30 and must be prepaid with a check made out to BHS. Registration deadline is October 1st, almost a week from today. Also, if you are in AP class this year, you must be signed in by the 22nd, allowing you to get an exam code. Don't worry though, your teacher should take care of giving you a class code by then, either as homework or as class activity. If you are self-studying for an AP, you must go to the link in the Monday memo and register. If you register after the 22nd, you will be charged an additional $40 as a late fee.
Just some information about the indoor mask mandate. It is still in place for the town of Bedford. DESE has stated that if schools reach 80% vaccination rate, mask wearing may be reevaluated after October 1st. However, as long as there is an indoor mask mandate in the town of Bedford, the high school will continue to wear masks in school. If the indoor mask mandate is lifted and BHS reaches 80% vaccination rate, then our school committee will be responsible for determining the policy for the high school. So BHS, continue to wear your masks. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ben.
I'm Connor.
I'm Nick.
And I'm Kai.
We're all part of BHS's male a cappella group called Buckapella.
And we're holding auditions on the 29th and 30th of September after school.
That's a Wednesday and a Thursday.
Yes.
Right after school.
Yes.
So, at this point of the week, you should have been sent an email with a form to sign up. And you will tell us what day. You can email this email right here.
That one.
I think.
If
you have any questions, or if you can't make either of those days and would like to audition. Bye, BHS.
Bye, BHS.
You. Help us.
I think.
Hey there, BHS. So if you guys were wondering if we have an LGBTQ+ club here, well, I'm here to tell you that we do. It is called SAGA, and it stands for Sexuality and Gender Alliance. Now, this club tends to meet after school, and we will discuss things like the events we set up, the fundraising that goes along with it, and we can answer any questions that you guys have. So if you are interested, we have our first meeting on Monday the 27th, which is next week, and you can come on down to B207 at 2:30 after school. So we hope to see you there.
Good morning, everyone. Subby here with a short senior information segment. Next week on Monday, there will be a senior parent guardian online meeting at 6:30 p.m. A Zoom link should have been sent out sometime this week, so check your inboxes. Next month, on the 8th, your baby or elementary school photos and your senior thanks will be due. You can submit these at the website www.hjeshare.com. with the code Bedford with a capital B. Make sure to include your name or else you might not make it into the yearbook. Later that month, on the 22nd, is when the final senior portraits are due, and if you haven't already done them, the school official photographers are Mark Lawrence Photography, and you can call them at 603-882-0116 to make an appointment. If you have any other questions for the yearbook, you can email them to the yearbook advisor at Karen_Santos, S-A-N-T-O-S, at bedfordps.org. Amazing turnout at Bedford Day, especially at the dump tank. Have an amazing day, BHS.
Hey guys, I just wanted to let you know that the Drowsy Chaperone cast list is out and rehearsals have officially started. Stay tuned for the ticket link, and the show will be in November, by the way. And if you're interested in stage crew, Ms. Fosdick sent out a link for a survey to fill out through BHS Student News.
Released. Here's a quick run through of all of the cast members and what roles they have been cast in. I apologize in advance for any mispronunciation. Connor McClung has been cast as Man and Cher. Carolyn Cruz has been cast as Mrs. Tottendale. John Mitchell has been cast as Underling. Jacob Choi has been cast as Robert. Healy Weissman has been cast as George. Ashutosh Budatoki has been cast as Feldzig. Mary Cuvée has been cast as Kitty. Ben Cuvée has been cast as Aldolfo. Ellie Mitchell has been cast as Janet. Heather Anderson has been cast as the Drowsy Chaperone. Maddie McAllister has been cast as Trix. Kate Galante has been cast as Gangster Number 1. Zoe Kramer has been cast as Gangster Number 2. Shannon Sullivan has been cast as Reporter 1. Rachel Gould has been cast as Reporter 2. Kai Ettringer has been cast as the Superintendent. And in the ensemble are Druthi Yuvaraj, Eve Fambu, Mary Stewart, Shannon Sullivan, Rachel Gould, Quinn Turner, Rehan Semi, Dylan DeJesus, and Kai Ettringer. Congratulations to the cast.
Hi, class of 2025. I'm here to give you updates on important information you need to know about the upcoming week. Next Monday, the 27th, will be the first meeting of the class of 2025 committee. All are welcome to come, and if you are interested, it will be held by Ms. Whiff and Ms. Barrett in H208 right after school. To get there, go up the stairs near the intersection of the G-Wing and H-Wing and enter the classroom on your left. We will be discussing and coming up with ways to promote our community and raise our class's spirit through exciting events, activities, and fundraisers. We hope to see you there.
Hey, what's up, gamers? Welcome to the Buccaneer Breakdown. Hey, what's the Buccaneer Breakdown, you might ask? Well, that's the brand new segment introduced and hosted by your boy, Triple X Dave, Triple X, Asu _ Shu. It's where we're going to go around, interview the most asked about teachers, and ask them the questions that you want to ask. And why we're doing this? Well, we want to foster a better teacher-student relationship and community in the school. And what better way than to interview the teachers that you want to interview? It'll be epic. It'll be great. It'll be fun. Be there or be square. Asu out.
So this month, from the 16th to the 23rd, was Bisexual Awareness Week. The week is used to celebrate the bisexual community as a whole, and bis, they represent about 40% of the LGBTQ plus community, which is why it is very important to educate yourself and ask questions, because it is a lot worse to assume and not accept the community.
Bisexuals unfortunately have to face very many stereotypes, remarks, and assumptions. It's heartbreaking that bisexuals have to face it. Being bisexual is more than just being bi, it's about loving who you love. The criticism of not only being bi, but being part of the LGBTQ community is horrible. So my best advice is just love who you love and be who you are.
Bye, BHS.